The Beatles!
The Beatles!
The Beatles!
The Beatles!
John!
Paul!
George!
Ringo!
The Beatles!
The Beatles! The Beatles!
It was all about the music. It was all about the songs. We were catching a ride on the rising tide that carried us along. Something in the rhythm that made me hear the call. It was all about the music after all.
For the Beatles themselves, it was all about the music. But for the fans, it was all about the Beatles. Hello, I'm Louise Harrison, and as many of you know, I'm George Harrison's big sister. I consider the global family of Beatle people as my extended family, and many of you think of me as the global mum. There have been countless books and articles written about the Beatles, but in this audio collection, you'll hear from the fans themselves. The voices that screamed with delight when the Beatles first appeared on Ed Sullivan, or cried with sadness the day they broke up. There are few whose lives have not been touched by the Beatles' talent and their gift of music. So we reached out to the fans and asked you to share with us your memories, your stories, and your heartfelt affection for the lads from Liverpool. We call it Fab Fan Memories.
1, 2, 3, 4!
She was just 17, and you know what I mean.
Beatlemania had begun and was in full force. More music-hungry fans joined the ranks with each passing day. Those who actually saw the excitement unfold now have more than a few grey hairs. Some are even bald. But they remember clearly their first impressions of the Beatles, as do those who discovered their music years later. What is your first memory of the Beatles?
Hello, I am Bonnie Keene from Nashville, Tennessee. I was 8 or 9 years old the first time I heard the Beatles on my little transistor radio in my bedroom. My very first memory of hearing them was hearing Help, and I was riveted by the sound. I had never heard anything like that, and I was playing with my Barbie dolls in the floor, and they immediately started dancing. I mean, I was all by myself. Help was on my transistor radio. I turned it up to Stun, and my Barbie dolls just went wild. That is truly what happened.
Now I'll never dance with another.
My name is Alan Benson, and I live in Green Acres, Florida. And my first recollection, anything at all about the Beatles, was in the sixth grade in 1964, in February. When they landed at JFK, our principal at Saddle Rock Elementary School, Mr. Atwan, burst into the classroom, turned on the television, and said, "The Beatles have landed at JFK," at which time the girls all started screaming. I was not even 12 yet. And I did not know who the Beatles were yet. And the girls were screaming, and I didn't know what was going on. All I know is that they came on the television, they showed them at JFK, getting off the plane, and the 15,000 screaming fans at the airport.
And before too long, I fell in love with her.
My name is Janice Ian. I've been a recording artist and a songwriter since I was 14 years old back in 1965. I was in camp in 1964, 13 years old, and my bunkmate was a girl named Janie Street, and we were the only two people who listened to pop music. She had fallen in love with the Stones and the Beatles, and so she dragged me to see Hard Day's Night. She somehow convinced the entire camp to go, so we all rode into town in Pawling, New York, on the back of a flatbed truck, about 30 of us, and we saw a Hard Day's Night. The music was unbelievable. I'd never heard that kind of energy in voices before. I'd never heard that kind of energy in playing. The blend of Lennon and McCartney, coupled with the songs, coupled with the really unusual changes you know, you can listen and you can say such and such did this before, such and such did that before. Yeah, other people did everything Miles Davis did before too. It's just Miles put it together new, and that's what they did.
Hey, I'm Jim. I'm originally from Inglewood, California. I must have been about 11 or 12, and I remember hearing a snippet of a song on the radio. It was From Me to You. What I remember is na 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 with that harmonica going, and I just went, what was that? And so I was on it from the jump. And then the first album that was popularly released in the United States was Meet the Beatles on Capitol. There was something about the Beatles, and I don't know what it was, that just spoke to me. That set the course for the rest of my life.
Hello, my name is Sean. I was going to Catholic grade school in upstate New York as a 10-year-old young boy. It was mandatory that all students bring their own lunch to school, and I had a metal lunchbox with the Beatles insignia on it and their instruments, and my box got passed around and was a really big hit. But that was really my first recollection of the Beatles and how impressed my peers were with the fact that I actually had a Beatles lunchbox.
Hi, we're the Bennett family, and we love the Beatles.
I'm Savannah. I'm 11. I'm a third-generation Beatles fan, and we are here because they're a major part of our lives.
Can I just chime in? Hi, I'm Brian. I'm a huge Beatles fan, and Savannah, my 11-year-old, is not just a Beatles fan. It really is a huge part of who she is. She listens to them constantly, and a lot of times at nighttime when I go to check on her in the middle of the night, I will see she has her headphones in for her iPod. So I'll go to turn it off, and sure enough, there she'll be listening to Rocky Raccoon or Obladi Oblada or some sort of Beatles song that has put her to sleep that night.
My name's Rod Davis, and I was one of John Lennon's original quarrymen. I grew up in Woolton on the outskirts of Liverpool, and my first memory of John was when I was 5 or 6 years old at Sunday school. He'd spend his couple of pennies, should have been his collection money, on bubble gum and chewing gum instead of putting it in the plate. And my mother used to tell me, now you keep away from that Lennon.